Hello Internet, this is Oscar Release again with another video on finding roots, this time on Muller's method. But before we get into the details of the method, let's first talk about David Eugene Muller. Dr. Muller earned his PhD in physics from Caltech in 1951. Then he worked at the University of Illinois for nearly 40 years as a professor of mathematics and computer science. He then became an adjunct professor of mathematics at NMSU. He was also a Fulbright professor at the University of Tokyo, and was a visiting professor at Michigan, UT, and the Technion. He was also a consultant for Bell Labs and IBM, and published more than 50 papers throughout his career, one of which became known as Muller's method. A method for solving algebraic equations using an automatic computer. It was published by the AMS in 1956 and has been cited more than 700 times. The automatic computer he was referring to was the ELIAC, which weighed 5 tons and had 2,800 vacuum tubes. It also didn't have a whole lot of memory by today's standards, and the runtime was measured in minutes. Muller's method you can imagine as a secant method, but with a parabola instead of a secant. We want to find the root of a continuous function f of x, and we use 3 points, x1, x2, and x3. We use those to compute a parabola that goes between those points, and then we test the x-intercepts of that parabola. Once we have tested both of them, we keep the better one and repeat with the last three x's. More on this later. Let's try to find the root of x cubed minus x squared minus x minus 1, which is this function here. And we need three starting points, x1, x2, and x3. They are the points 0, 1, and 2. To find the parabola that goes through these 3 points, we can use the Lagrange polynomial. I recommend watching my video on Lagrange polynomial if you haven't already. Plug in our numbers to find this function, which we can simplify as 2x squared minus 3x minus 1. So if we graph both of those functions, they should match at those 3 points, which they do. Now we need to test the x-intercepts of our Lagrange function, but how do we find those? To find the roots of our function 2x squared minus 3x minus 1, we can use a quadratic equation. Plug in our values of a, b, and c, and we get this result for x4, which is actually two numbers. So we have to test both of those numbers on our original function, and we keep the one that's closer to 0, which in this case is 1.781. This means we now have 4 points. We'll only keep the last three though, which will give us our new parabola. That parabola looks something like this, and we'll repeat the process. So in summary, we use 3 points to find a Lagrange polynomial. Then we computed a, b, and c of that Lagrange polynomial and solved it using the quadratic equation. Afterwards, we tested both roots and we kept the better one. Muller's method simplifies all these steps though. This is the representation of Muller's method that I like, which uses points for a, b, and c, sort of resembling our quadratic equation approach that we saw earlier. Here, the points a, b, and c are computed using these three equations. Notice that there's a variable called q, which is actually just given by this function here. Let's look at an example of Muller's method, which is x cubed minus x squared minus x minus 1. We'll use an epsilon of 10 to the minus 7th, and we'll test it twice, once with the starting points of 0, 1, and 2, and the second time with the starting points of negative 2, negative 1, and 0. Our first approach is going to use the points 0, 1, and 2, and it found the root in about 4 iterations, the value of 1.83929. But where Muller's method really shines is in finding complex roots. For our second approach, let's use the starting points of minus 2, minus 1, and 0. And in this case, it took about 5 iterations to find the root, which was this complex number here. But by the complex conjugate root theorem, we actually found 2 roots. So we found all 3 roots of our function. Let's talk about the order of Muller's method. And remind you that I kind of referred to Muller's method as secant method, but with 3 points. The order of secant method is about 1.618, which is the root of the function x squared minus x minus 1. That number is called the golden ratio. For Muller's method, the order is about 1.83929, which is the root of this function here. Hey, that's the one we solved earlier. This actually has a special name too. It's known as the Tribonacci constant, which is this beautiful number here. Some things to note, Muller's method is faster than secant method, but still slower than Newton's method, although it doesn't require a derivative. And it is pretty good at finding complex roots like in our examples. The code that I used to find these routes will be hosted on GitHub. The link will be in the description below the video. Special thanks to Dr. Gates and Dr. Grinovich from UTEP, as well as Drs. Lackey, Pontelli, and Julian from NMSU for helping to track down information on Dr. Muller. As always, thanks for watching, and if you have suggestions for future videos that you would like me to make, please be sure to leave them in the comments.